The following video today is brought to you by Quip. Stay tuned until the end of the video to find out more about the world's greatest toothbrush. Back in 2016, one of the biggest memes around was Humongous. What started as a simple punchline to a dad joke became a full-out saga online, with many twists and turns. So whatever happened to the man behind the joke? Well, before we get to that, let's take a look back at where this all started. This story began with a Facebook post from Seattle-based feminist Zarna Joshi, who on August 11th, 2016, shared her encounter with a man who supposedly sexually harassed her. Zarna's statement went like this: "That same guy then sexually harassed me, and when I asked him why he was sexually harassing me, he kept doing it. When I raised my voice and told everyone what he was doing, he ran away. The security guards who witnessed everything then accosted me to tell me to be quiet. When I asked them why they were going after me instead of the man who sexually harassed me, they called the cops on me." If you just heard her story, it sounded like this man, along with observers, really treated her unfairly. But fortunately, she recorded the whole incident on camera. To put it lightly, this footage painted a different picture.
You take the right picture.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
You want my name?
Yeah, sure.
It's Humongous.
Okay. Humongous what? Humongous what?
Humongous.
Humongous what?
Humongous.
Humongous what?
Humongous.
Humongous what?
That's what it is.
Humongous what? Is that sexual harassment?
No, it's humongous.
Then why did you say that to me?
That's my name.
What? Humongous what?
Humongous what?
Why would you say that to me?
Why would I say it to
Why
you?
Would you say that to me?
Why would you ask me my name?
What? Humongous what? This person just spoke to me in a sexually harassing way.
I did not.
Yeah, he did.
Oh,
he said, do you know what my name is?
No,
and
I said,
what?
You want my
and
name.
He said, Humongous.
What?
Yeah.
What?
Yeah. This person just sexually harassed me.
I said, I'm Humongous.
Yes. Yeah, that's right.
For years, I was completely confused why Zarna even started flipping out about sexual harassment. But it just dawned on me now that she thought he was alluding to his penis being humongous. I feel like an idiot for never really understanding that until now, but I guess it just goes to show how unjustified her outburst really was. Despite for most people it being clear she was in the wrong, in the confines of her Facebook community, people were taking her side and sharing in the outrage. Once someone re-uploaded the video on YouTube, however, public opinion started to shift. The video was sent around Twitter and Reddit, with many anti-SJW political pundits starting to use it as another example of the left being out of control. By far, the people who signal boosted the story of Humongous the most was Ethan and Ela of H3H3 Productions. Their channel was in a golden age of sorts, and this story was perfect for them to comment on.
Today, guys, we bring you the most triggered woman I have ever seen. And we've seen triggered feminists, we've seen people getting triggered over video games, over Tumblr, over all kinds of wacky stuff, but this one truly takes the cake. So without further ado, guys, let's jump into the triggered to the triggered power. Triggered squared equals triggered infinity.
In response to the outpouring of criticism and mockery, Zarna doubled down on being the victim in the situation. She released a video on her channel about how all white people are racist, even if they don't actually do anything racist, and how all men are complicit in rape culture. This, of course, didn't go over very well, with her disabling her ratings. As if that wasn't enough stoking of the flames, she also requested that people donate to her You Caring campaign. The money would be used for her safety and well-being. I don't think I need to state that she didn't raise much. In fact, much of the funds she did receive were from people sending the minimum $1 requirements just so they could send her a mocking message. On top of this, Ethan Klein sent her $100 to see if she had the integrity to turn it down. While this was going on, people discovered the true identity of Humongous, whose real name turned out to be Rudy Dantoga. The story is that he was at City Hall in support of the local police department as they helped take his drug-abusing daughter off the streets so she could get treatment, before being approached by Zarna for the infamous video. He told all of this in an interview with H3.
All of a sudden, I see these eyes looking at me. First, I thought she had cute guy disorders, and I must have taken a cute pill today because she's definitely giving me the eye.
It ended up not that she didn't find you cute at all.
No, it was like having a. It was almost like a domestic dispute,
yeah.
Or a girlfriend,
yeah,
kicking me out of the house.
As Zarna was trying to get money, people discovered that Rudy suffered from actual health problems which prevented him from working, and he truly needed help. So someone set up a You Caring campaign for him that quickly raised thousands of dollars before the website shut down both of the pages. This didn't stop the internet's effort, however, as they quickly set up a GoFundMe page for Humongous to start where the last one left off. It quickly made it to the six-figure range as people wanted to help the meme in need. Later on, once he started to receive the donations, Rudy appeared on the H3 podcast to express his gratitude to everyone who helped him out. That night, the internet could give themselves a nice pat on the back. And now that the goal was accomplished, updates about Rudy's life started to become less frequent, and people moved on to new things. The last I remember hearing about Rudy was back in 2017 when he announced he would be running for city council in Seattle that year. While he had unsuccessfully run for office multiple times in the past, people thought that the power of memes would make a difference, as voters would now back him to stick it to those no-good feminists. But he ended up losing, coming in a distant fourth place. In fact, looking at the other elections he was in, he received a smaller percentage of the vote in 2017 than any other time he had run. This just goes to show that the internet doesn't always benefit meme politicians, like it did Donald Trump. After this, Humongous kinda just fell off the map. Ethan and Hila stopped their non-stop coverage of his life, Zarna stopped fighting with the internet, and everyone kinda just went on with their life. Although it should be noted that his GoFundMe campaign is still up and receiving donations frequently. In fact, someone just gave him $100 a day ago. Also, it appears despite his health problems and failed political run, Rudy is still staying involved with his local government. I was able to find a news report from May of 2019 where he attended a city council meeting where he was talking about improving the Seattle neighborhood he lived in, and he didn't look sickly, so I hope he's doing well. As for what Zarna has been up to, after scrolling through the H3 subreddit for a bit, I discovered a few posts talking about how in 2019 she is showing up at local high schools and giving presentations on the subject of global warming and how rich white men are responsible. Some claim that they yelled Humongous at her during the speech, and then she went off about sexual harassment, and others were able to get a selfie. It doesn't appear that she's changed very much. So there you have the story of Humongous, a kind man with an interest in local politics who was whisked into the spotlight after being screamed at by a feminist and therefore became the center of the anti-SJW movement because of it. While his 15 minutes of fame have ended, hopefully that GoFundMe money continues to have a positive effect on his life. Hey everybody, thank you so much for making it to the end of this video today, and before I leave, I just need to tell you that you have to buy a Quip toothbrush today. It's that summer vacation time of year, and one of the biggest pain in the necks while packing is your toiletries. Getting everything to fit can be a complete hassle, but the compact and wireless design of a Quip toothbrush can make it very easy to put one in your carry-on, or in your back pocket when you're just staying the night. Plus, on top of that, with the travel-ready cover, it protects your brush from sandy swimsuits and luggage slip-ups. I love my Quip toothbrush for its sensitive sonic vibrations that lead to an effective clean that's gentle on my sensitive gums. On top of that, it's just so easy because every 3 months they send you a new brush head so you don't have to worry about it. That's why I love Quip and why I brought it with me to VidCon this year. Quip starts at just $25, and if you go to getquip.com/whathappened right now, you can get your first refill pack for free. That's your first refill pack for free at getquip.com/whathappened.